to the agony of qualifying, England tonight look ahead to the World Cup. And with his lineup to meet fellow qualifiers, Northern Ireland, Ron Greenwood is clearly saying to a number of players, prove to me that you're the right man for Spain. Kevin Keegan and Brian Robson are the two players who played against Hungary, although of course Tony Morley came on as a substitute on that occasion. Steve Foster now wins his first cap at the age of 24 as the 35-year-old Dave Watson takes his number to 64. The other members of the team are squad players yet to claim a first-choice place. For Billy Bingham, the task is as ever to get the most from limited resources. Sammy Nelson returns at left-back, with Mal Donaghy moving to midfield at the expense of David McCreary, still feeling the effects of crossing the Atlantic. But no ill effects for Pat Jennings. He passed the fitness test this morning and makes his 90th appearance for his country. Glenn Hoddle comes back, though with a winger who's tended in the past to want the ball to feet. And Steve Foster gets his chance in part because of the ill luck of others. Gwyn Owen of Wales is the referee, and it's the best of Northern Ireland against some of the best of England. And that is Billy Bingham has reminded the Irish side that in 1958, when they went to their only previous World Cup finals, they won here at Wembley on the way there. Steve Foster probably setting some sort of record as the first England player to appear for his country wearing a headband. It covers scar tissue. Robson, Foster, getting some early touches. Here's Hoddle, and immediately feeling the presence of the marker, Donaghy. This is Anderson, and the run by Francis. Oh, and a marvellous opening. Brian Robson, the scorer. All smiles among the England players. Francis making the run deep into the Irish defence. Anderson who found him, look at the space that he had. Just went wide of his man, pulled it back as Robson pulled away from his marker and was unmarked when he scored. And England could hardly ask for a better start. There's Noah Brotherston. Ball was out before Morley played it. Listen to the buzz that that sent around Wembley. Haven't seen the best of England at Wembley for quite a long time. The victory against Hungary was the first success in six matches. But the crowd have got the start they were looking for. Kenny Sansom and Noel Brotherston. And Brotherston, the player for whom Sansom has marked respect. Here's Keegan, and the Irish really haven't settled down at all. Giving England players a lot of space. Keegan, though, never made up his mind what he was going to do. Here's McElroy. Sort of ball that Huddle wins comfortably getting goal side. And that's all England can expect of him, to get goal side of his man and force the man that he's marking to pass the ball back or square. As long as he doesn't allow someone to run at the England defence, then surely he's doing sufficiently in his defensive chore. Sammy Nelson. On the same pitch as the man who replaced him at Arsenal, Kenny Sansom. Throw from further back. Turn by Hamilton. Watson there. Keegan. Francis right, Morley left. And Keegan again, not making up his mind early enough, it seemed to me. Jennings beaten before he had a chance to get into any sort of action. Foster, it went slightly backwards off his head, that's Anderson. Brings attacking possibilities, as indeed does the man he's replaced, Phil Neal. There's Watson. Foster looking for 11, Hamilton. And he created the gap into which the throw was played. Put out by Wilkins for the corner. Which Sammy McElroy will take. McElroy these days of Stoke City. Hamilton on the line. Armstrong also in the six-yard box. And Clements having to cover, but it went for the goal kick. It's Billy Hamilton of Burnley. Wilkins from deep. And at the moment playing with Keegan and Francis forward. Morley slightly behind those two on the left side. Francis. Donaghy. Nelson. Intended for Morley. Too much movement for Sansom. Francis, we nearly got a foot in. Sansom. Useful from Brotherston. First test of any sort for Foster. Well, it proved not to be a test at all. Armstrong just lost control. Wilkins. Offside against Keegan. Hamilton and Armstrong, the forward players for Northern Ireland. And Wilkins playing exclusively at the back. Coming forward now from there. Oh, that's a lovely ball from Francis de Morley. Question of pace. Nicol is the defender. No foul. And he couldn't get away from Jimmy Nicol. But it was a beautiful ball by Trevor Francis that put Morley through in the first place. Robson. Morley once more. Trevor Francis making his 24th appearance for his country. Keegan. Nelson. McElroy. Foster getting himself in a bit of trouble. Covered by Wilkins. Donaghy. Brotherston. Again the clearance from Wilkins, who is virtually playing as a spare man at the back for England, Ray Wilkins. Ron Greenwood tried out this plan in the match for the late Bill Taylor, and he seems to be persevering with it in a full international here. Free kick given against Foster. Two of four to come from Ray Clements' left. Nobody really on the near post, but Hamilton might go there. Nelson takes. Morley. Sanson making the forward run for Morley. Brotherston's come with him. Good challenge. And in fact, the linesman saw it as a free kick. Obviously didn't feel that Brotherston got up alongside sufficient enough to make a proper challenge. Francis left the penalty spot. Foster is over on the far side. McElroy. Keegan. Back by Watson. And the flag up for offside, and I'm afraid I cannot tell you against whom until the referee points to where Keegan was standing. Just have a feeling that Gwyn Herring might have been a little surprised by the linesman's flag as well. Keegan's certainly playing well forward and has been caught offside a couple of times. Here's Armstrong. McElroy. Useful. Did so well. He got through quite a crowd. Set up in the heart of the England defence, not looking too happy then to a player who attacked them on the ground. It's Chris Nicol for Northern Ireland. Foster winning in the air. Donaghy. Robson, head tennis in midfield. Foster. Middle finding a bit of space for Anderson. Bottle number 10, certainly the chief task, I think, of Mal Donaghy to pick him up in midfield. He's just looking across at the other now. And the free kick. Hoddle has Watson up on the far side. Keegan and Foster nearer. Met by Nelson. Martin O'Neill. This is McElroy. Brotherson making a diagonal run. Armstrong out on the left. Sanson's clearance. Jimmy Nicol. Two Nichols and two O'Neills on the Irish side. Too long. Donaghy made the forward run and got himself offside. Wilkins. Brotherston. Morley with no need to play it. Sensor. Wilkins from the back. Leaving England with two or sometimes three in midfield because Morley is certainly not in the front line. O'Neill, Brotherston. The 90th meeting between these two sides. England with 69 victories, Northern Ireland with 6. Wilkins to Francis. Morley on the touchline. Sanson in the inside left position. Morley with a chance across it, Hoddle's in the box. Sanson who went for it. And the free kick ball put up by Martin O'Neill. Morley. And back inside, Jennings to meet. And I think Ron Greenwood would like to see Morley attack the space behind the fullback, and there was space there then. John O'Neill, Leicester City. Jimmy Nicol, once again of Manchester United. Sunderland couldn't afford the fee. Hamilton beating Watson. Brotherston. We've had the first quarter of an hour of the match. We've had the first goal scored by England. Chris Nicol. Armstrong. Brotherston. Might be one of the contests within the game. Kenny Sansom and Noel Brotherston. Wembley not full, but certainly a bigger crowd than the last time these two sides met when only 35,000 turned up. For a one-all draw. Keegan. Robson. McElroy. The long legs of Anderson get in and ride the tackles. Keegan in the middle. It's a corner. Foster and Watson up. Foster going to the line. Watson on the far angle of the six-yard area from the kicker's viewpoint. The kicker is Hoddle, looking for Watson, where he jumped on Chris Nicol. And Watson thought his career at international level was at an end when he didn't play against Hungary. Jennings has had just three reserve games since his injury in the third round of the Cup. Donaghy. Keegan forward. England at times seem to be somewhat bereft of numbers in attack. Sansom. Keegan. Armstrong, Anderson, Hoddle. More anticipation as Hoddle got possession. Sansom. That's a bit loose and was well won. A look then by Wilkins. Free kick given against Sammy Nelson. Followed through with the challenge on Francis. Morley staying square. Watson. Francis. Watson has continued a forward run. Keegan let it go to Watson. The opportunity was set up by Keegan letting it run. If we get movement from the front players, it does enable players from further back to come into bits of space. Hoddle with the kick, met by Morley. Wilkins the back man as Northern Ireland come away. Sanson across. Huddleston square of Armstrong. So is McElroy. It's Jimmy Nicol. O'Neill, Brotherston, goal kick, and Brotherston and Hamilton as he got up were hoping for something more. Certainly Clements thought that that was going to be a pickup, and in the end his body knocked the attacker, but there could be no question that Clements was trying to get the ball. Here's Wilkins. There's free roll at the back. He's sure to be encouraged to come forward from there. Here's Hoddle. Sansom was the furthest player forward. Jackson and Robson together. Green ball. And Robson looking as Jimmy Nicol climbed out of the camera pit. Nicol. Chris Nicol. Hamilton and Armstrong together. Armstrong. Foster, but didn't make it. Armstrong looks up, saw Brotherston wide, but couldn't find him. It's Foster's back pass. Francis. Sansom. Foster. Hoddle given the ball when he was marked by two, but that's quite common at Tottenham. Wilkins. Morley. Took their eye off the ball. Robson. Second confrontation. Oh, that might come to Keegan. Chance for the shots. Too much is going right for Kevin Keegan at the moment. Ironic, but his best move so far is when he didn't touch the ball, let it run to Watson. Hamilton and Anderson. Hamilton coming in from the goal side of Anderson. Francis, and Keegan is offside. He was the only one up then. As a lot of people would be pleased to see him so far forward. Brotherston, O'Neill, too strong, looking for the run in by Armstrong. Missed the game against Israel when Northern Ireland claimed their place in Spain. Was an injury then. Wilkins. Watson. Sansom giving now an extra man in midfield, which is sometimes needed. Here's Nicol. Brotherston. Across. Armstrong comfortably able to play that away. But here's Anderson. Only one player forward to play it to. Now Anderson giving an extra one on the right. Here was the one who was forward all the time, Keegan. O'Neill. McElroy. Nicely away from Huddle. Huddle there before Donaghy. Robson. Swept out to Morley. And Wilkins is forward this time. So is Francis. Robson is square. Now Wilkins is square. The Irish have got a lot back. Hoddle's found some space. And Anderson has found some outside him. Watson. Thank you. McElroy's pulled everybody back, and McElroy leads the counter. Armstrong is the only other one up. Foster will feel better for that. Brotherston. Armstrong. Nelson. McElroy. Wilkins comes to him. Going for the ball that wasn't played, in fact. And hurt himself in the process. Martin O'Neill. Queuing up in the middle, and Hamilton, but if he got a touch, it was only the slightest touch. Wilkins. Foster. Morley. So far has taken every pass to feet. Francis, followed by Chris Nicholl. England seem to have gained comfort in defence at the expense of numbers and variations going forward. Next time across to work out a new pattern, put up by Robson. Ball by Keegan back. Two men more. Six Irishmen in attacking positions. Not one of them is there. Watson. Looked not easy, but it was the only ball on for Watson. And too often that seems to have been the case. There's nothing on for the man in possession. I'll huddle with a bit more time. Francis. Morley going left side. But behind the play, here he is. Keegan and Francis were around the penalty spot. Goal kick. Wilkins have got on the end. We've had half an hour of the match. And the only goal came inside the first minute. 49 seconds, we made it. Scored by Brian Robson. Brotherston. Wilkins. Keegan. Hoddle. Keegan. By Armstrong, and he's got Hamilton to the left. Oh, and he ran into him rather than giving it to him, but here's Hamilton. Irish had a real chance then of getting right at the throat of England. And here's O'Neill. Foster. John O'Neill. Brotherston. Four players in a line with the far post. Nelson takes. One by Watson, then by Anderson. McElroy. Still plenty of green shirts forward. Chris Nicol. Anderson. Robson. Francis. Hoddle and Robson forward of the ball. And Keegan and Morley by no means together. Here's Jimmy Nicol. Martin O'Neill. Donaghy. Number three covering the middle, just outside the 18-yard area and being pushed forward by Ray Wilkins. Wilkins now at the back, Sanson in front of him. Nelson. Brian Robson, whose goal was his second for England. The crowd would clearly like to see more. Nelson for Northern Ireland. Or a push against Robson. Referee's arm stays down, so it was the push. McElroy could have a go. Chipper Francis now coming from the deepest position. Hoddle. Wilkin Square. That's for Morley. His control took it away from himself. Foster. Anderson. Moving up. Wilkins huddle on the touchline. Anderson, one of the forwards. Number two. And both the fullbacks have found room to get forward. Huddle for the corner. Out by Donaghy. Was out before McElroy played it. Foster. Watson. Isn't a good one. The impression if the Irish were to do simple things, they might just cause a few problems. Nicol, O'Neill, Donaghy. The space for Nicol. Well, pull it back. Foster just got a touch. Now Hoddle. Wilkins to Morley, finds two onto him. Foul on Robson. boos from the crowd, but dare I say it, if Morley plays in Spain, he'll find a fair bit of that sort of thing. Wilkins. The gap for Wilkins to go into, but he played it backwards. Nelson. Hoddle. It's a bit too long. Hamilton. Nelson. McElroy. Donaghy. Featherston. Handball by Wilkins. O'Neill. McElroy. Came off Robson. Seemed to stretch a bit. Keegan. Henderson purring forward. So is Robson. But the header wasn't a good one. And Keegan is now in the right back position. John Foster then by Hamilton, and Keegan has started to come to look for it. Watson. Huddle. Wilkins. Good run forward by Sampson, but he couldn't take it on. Chris Nicol. Keegan. McElroy made that look more comfortable than he should have been allowed to. O'Neill. Brotherston. If you can give it back, Nichols made the run. That took Morley, in fact. 5 minutes of the half remaining. England leading by the only goal. O'Neill. Brotherston, offside, against Martin O'Neill. And Huddle's had a quiet first half, but he can hardly be expected to produce club form if his colleagues are not playing and making the sort of runs they do for him at Tottenham. Robson. Nelson. McElroy. Free kick England's way. Defender Sammy Nelson. Huddle. And offside given against Brown. chances. It must have been a bit tight. I think it's the first time that a run has been made like that. And Francis turns to applaud the attempt by Huddle to get him in. Brotherston. Keegan. Huddle. Wilkins. Sends him. Francis has gone up to the left. Anderson. Huddle just inside. Plenty of players in the box for England. Wilkins. Be encouraged by the crowd to have a go. Foster. O'Neill of Leicester. Hamilton, McElroy, no problems for Ray Clements, and the wall for Morley. And Morley can pick it up and go right. Huddle, Keegan unmarked on the left side. Across the Irish line again. A groan of disappointment. Francis! Well, the opportunity to turn then for Francis. But I think we see as he turned, and there was space there as he turned to his right, the shot was always rising. Kick to Northern Ireland, a bit of holding down. Nelson. Watson lost out. Wilkins, Brotherston, Sansom. Huddle. Not there. Another good ball from McElroy. Morley. That's a good ball. Huddle to Keegan. And Keegan is another who's been in good form with his club, who hasn't been able to show it at international level so far on this particular occasion. Here's Donaghy. Set his sights. No mean attempt from a man who scored 7 times for Luton this season. Took his time. After the work had been done by Armstrong, two were on opposite sides on Saturday, and Donaghy struck it well, and it wasn't really too far wide, although I think Clements had it covered. And the last opportunity of the first half that was, and England go off leading by the only goal made by the run of Trevor Francis and scored by Brian Robson. The Irish certainly caught cold at the start. Trevor Francis finding all sorts of space. And just look, as Robson, I think we'll see him at the bottom of the picture. He pulls away and is quite unmarked as the ball is pulled back. Goal scored after 49 seconds, but for much of the rest of the half, the Irish giving as good as they got. Statistics of the first half would back up the comment that it was fairly even. just 6 goal attempts, 3 each. Really, for the crowd who come out on a very cold night, seeing just 6 shots at goal is certainly not what they paid for. Here's Noel Brotherston. And Ron Greenwood didn't like his side being called an experimental side, but certainly with Ray Wilkins in this role as a spare man at the back, it certainly has looked an experimental side so far. Here's Noel Brotherston. As the half went on, we saw more and more of Francis and Keegan and company coming back. But here, going forward, is Tony Morley. A little ambitious if you hope to get it between two and round Pat Jennings. Hamilton calling for it. McElroy. Morley starting this half on the right side. Wilkins living a little dangerously. Foster, Wilkins, Watson. And the pass again was square, and Sanson had to come back to collect. Chris Nicol. Foster. Francis. Oh, by Jerry Armstrong. Just to emphasize the evenness, the free kicks in the first half were also equal, 7 to either side. Anderson, huddle with Donaghy, Wilkins, Keegan, Wilkins, that's a good try, well, Pat Jennings had come to meet it, and I think we see as he put his arms aloft to make the catch, they locked rock solid. Foster, Anderson, Morley. Chance for Keegan. The bounce is kind, but it wasn't. Huddle. Rounding the ball. That's good to see. McElroy. Anderson seemingly moving late, but got there in plenty of time. Anderson. Morley. Francis, 3 in the middle. Oh, that's a good angle cross. Keegan! What a good cross. And Keegan goes to Trevor Francis. And for the England captain, that's goal number 21 for England. Morley, Francis making the run. He got absolutely to the teeth of the line and pulled it back at such a lovely angle, which beat the defence and set up Keegan, with Jennings having to try to recover the weight on his correct foot. So, as in the first half, England score early in the second too. 4 minutes of the second half gone, Keegan the scorer, and Trevor Francis, for the second time this evening, the provider. Morley. Francis. Robson making the run this time. Hoddle wants it outside. Wilkins is there as well. Morley. That's nicely done. Corner on the left. Keegan here pushing it through the gap. And Morley, it was a nifty little turn. And England in the second half having more at the goal than the first. Here's Hoddle. He's looked a difficult one to keep down. England seemingly have begun the second half stung by the statistics of the first. Watson. Keegan again. Francis. Good play by Jimmy Nicol. Really did well twice then, Jimmy Nicol. Cheers. Sort of buzz we had at the opening, which sadly died in the first period. Wilkins. Morley. Keegan. Sorts of possibilities now. Hoddle. Again, Jimmy Nicol got up well. Armstrong. Robson. Kick to Northern Ireland, challenged by Robson. In fact, the referee's given a throw. I thought he'd signal the free kick. Martin O'Neill, Sammy Nelson, put under pressure by Morley. And the crowd enjoying the change in the English team's outlook. O'Neill. Nicol. Donaghy. Hoddle just got a foot in, but not completely. Donaghy stuck to his task well. Anderson. Morley. A little wrestling with Martin O'Neill. Robson. Hoddle. And away goes Francis. And that's the sort of combination that England were looking to see. But again, Jimmy Nicol has done very well. Hoddle once more. Francis. Suddenly the England players are all calling for the ball. Totally different concept from the first half. Wilkins. Almost very nice. Well played by O'Neill. And Brotherston head down. 10 minutes of the second half have gone. And I would warrant the crowd have enjoyed them a great deal more than all but the first minute of the first half. Keegan, Francis, Morley. And in comes Kenny Stenson. Is it built on one side with Morley, and Francis pulled out in case the angle was going to be changed, but Morley went ahead with the cross. Sanson had so much space coming in, hit it somewhat spectacularly and somewhat high. Nickel. Watson. McElroy. Armstrong. Hamilton down the middle, looking offside. He's all right now. Here's Sansom. He's made the room for the turn. Met by Wilkins, Hamilton. And no one there to come in on it. Brotherston. McElroy. Armstrong seeking to find room from a more right-sided position. McElroy, that's a good run. Got a man over too, who's Donaghy, but the cross is too long. Keegan calling for it straight down the middle. Francis running from left to right. Foster. Hamilton. Nickel. Donaghy. You know, he wasn't sure where he was going to go. Here's O'Neill. Nelson thinking about moving forward. Number three. England all back by Keegan. And Nickel trying to find his fellow fullback, Nelson. Needing two more caps after tonight for his 50. Up by Watson. Morley got it rather blindly away. Francis miscued it. He was looking for Keegan. Francis moving somewhat gingerly. Chris Nickel. Brotherston. Anderson going in when he didn't need to. And here's Armstrong. McElroy far post. This is second time the pass has been just too long to the far post when hit from the right side. Anderson. Wilkins. Keegan and Francis forward. Cyril Regis warming up on the running track. Reason for the buzz going around the ground. And that's a lovely ball from Keegan, from Hoddle to Keegan. And a corner. And he turns to applaud the pass. And it was beautifully played. Changed the angle, put in a man behind two defenders. The third went with him. And Pat Jennings got a left hand. Hoddle with the corner. Off Hamilton. Wilkins. Pat Jennings looking in sharp form to what was the most teasing pass that Hoddle's played in the match. A couple of times we've seen combination between Hoddle and Francis, and there between Hoddle and Keegan. Surely Ron Greenwood will say to this man, you're in my side, and we'll soldier along with you. Francis. Francis still feeling the knock. And Robson, scorer of the first goal. Watson. Foster a bit fortunate, and here's Kenny Sansom. Hoddle. Sansom. Robson. Sansom. He stood in the cul-de-sac. I thought he got away, but he didn't. Foster. Puts it back in the same area. Francis. And that's a free kick against Martin O'Neill. Trying to break things up. Seemed to rather stand on Trevor Francis's toe. Come down to bring on a possible substitute. Anderson couldn't get there. Go kick. But he doesn't want us to know just yet who is coming on. It will be Cochrane. Featherston, Nelson, Kevin minutes of the second half gone. 2-0 the score to England. Robson. Brotherston. Wilkins to meet him. Huddle. Keegan. Brotherston's door feeling a knock that he got then. Trevor Francis. Three in the middle. One of them is Anderson. Cyril Regis is going to get his chance in place of the injured Trevor Francis. Regis becomes the 26th new cap to be awarded by Ron Greenwood. And Northern Ireland also made a substitution. Cochrane, as I thought, coming on in place of Noel Brotherston. Cochrane, who scored the equaliser here in the last meeting between these two teams back in May 1980. Robson's cross. Hoddle loses out to Hamilton. Francis has been substituted in the past and gone off a very disappointed man, but having been deeply involved in both goals, he won't be disappointed tonight. And Cyril Regis now has a chance of about 25 minutes, a little less, to show what he can do. Man with 19 goals for West Bromwich Albion this season, including two hat-tricks. Here's Sanson. Bounce around a little bit, Sanson like a dodgem car, but he hasn't got too much from that corner in this half. Billy Hamilton. Positive. Straight run, and he was tripped by Ray Wilkins. Jimmy Nicol was the last to place the ball down. He's got three players on the left side. O'Neill takes it. It came off the ground, but had no power to test Ray Clements. Good recovery by Donaghy. And here's Keegan. Nelson across. They're ganging up in the middle. One of them is Regis! And he was there almost too early, but managed to get his head round, to get a header to try and knock it wide of Pat Jennings. Touched it quite comfortably in the end. And the crowd shouting, come on Cyril, let's have another one. Nicol. Cochrane. And he's in. Time that Ray Clements has been forced into any real action, and he was so then by the substitute. Here's Morley. What a difference the second half is. Anderson. And the free kick given. Donaghy sending Viv Anderson for all the world as though Anderson was about to make a long jump. Keegan on the near side, Foster! And the goal was screamingly vacant. Came off the Irish defender from Hoddle's free kick. And the pressure from Keegan there, and Foster had so much to look at, but put it over. Minutes left. 2-0 the score. Here's McElroy for Northern Ireland. Never less than 100%er. Donaghy. McElroy. Sanson not quite there. Nicol. Anderson. Robson. Morley pulling away to the right. Wilkins well forward. Wilkins. Morley, but he's got Ball and Nelson at the same time. Huddle. Wilkins wanted it square, but Huddle wanted to look for it forward. Regis had gone too soon. Chris Nicol. O'Neill, John O'Neill, Hamilton, and the push by Foster. Chris Nicol making his way forward on the far side, now at a steady sprint. Hamilton, Cochrane, Keegan, Wilkins, into space for Sanson. Robson is inside, number 8. Nobody coming from behind at any great pace there for England. Jerry Armstrong of Watford. McElroy. Turnbull, a disappointing one. Morley with a lot of room to have a go. Keegan in the van. Anderson just inside Morley. Regis in a line with the far post. And here he is. Picks out Brian Robson, who picks out a lemon. Again, to emphasise the differences between club football and international football, Cyril Regis comes into this side and finds himself playing with a winger, which he's not been used to all this season with West Bromwich Albion. Foster, Dave Watson, Sanson looking for Keegan, Huddle, just the nick, positive play by Chris Nicol. Oh dear, oh dear. Oh, I was describing Kenny Sanson as being a bit like a dodging car. He was certainly taken right off his axis then. Keegan, challenge from behind by O'Neill, Wilkins, Anderson, Huddle, and the diving attempt by Cyril Regis. And he flung himself at it. Huddle got in here, and Regis flung himself at it, and it came off Chris Nicol. for the corner. Rich Regis is coming on a long run. 15 minutes left. Cochrane for Northern Ireland. McElroy, Donaghy availing himself square. Sam Nelson, Foster and Hamilton, Martin O'Neill. And what the number eight did at one end, the other number eight has done at the other. Regis, nice touch to Robson, former club colleague. McElroy. Donaghy. O'Neill, Donaghy. It will be O'Neill's last touch in the match. Here's Jim Cochran. I beg his pardon, Terry Cochran. Oh, unbelievable bounce. Keegan. Morley. Trying to get Regis in. Handball and given. And more substitutions to be made. Mr. Owen sees the activity on the bench. Northern Ireland are going to replace Martin O'Neill with David McCreary. And Tony Morley is going to be replaced by Tony Woodcock. But play is continuing. And now the substitutions can be made. Martin O'Neill being replaced by David McCreary, these days of Tulsa Roughnecks. And a brief chance for England to change the pattern a bit. Morley has gone off. And Woodcock has come on. So it's a new permutation up front. Woodcock, who's been having a good season with Cologne in West Germany. Sansom. Bit of obstruction by Donaghy. Wilkins. Sansom. Keegan, the point of the attack. McElroy. Robson, Hoddle, Woodcock. Sanson coming from behind, number three. Hoddle. What a movement. Regis, Wilkins, Woodcock. This is better. Sanson, Wilkins, Hoddle. A lot of passes, will there be an end product? Robson. Out by Chris Nicol. Now, possibility for Northern Ireland. I thought he was pushed, the referee didn't agree. Robson. Tony Woodcock, his last appearance was against Scotland last season. And he's got 10 minutes left to play. as indeed as everybody else. Hamilton. Nicely taken down by Wilkins. Sansom. Woodcock. Hoddle. Keegan. He just takes two men away by the run. Here's Sansom. Hoddle. Back again for Sansom, but too long. The official attendance, 54,900. Anderson, Foster, Wilkins, Robson, Keegan, Robson, Regis, Regis once again, Watson, Anderson unlucky twice. Foster disappointed with the referee's decision. The bow was not to scrape, but to offer a different opinion. Nicol. Armstrong. Keegan, Hoddle, and it worked, Robson, Armstrong, who certainly worked hard, Wilkins, Woodcock, Robson, Woodcock has gone on, and might be found. Jennings seemingly squashing the ball in those big hands as he came forward. It was close for Robson and Woodcock. Hamilton, Jerry Armstrong, Regis, I'm going to come deep to get a look at it here. Anderson, confident play by John O'Neill. Who wants a transfer from Leicester City because of his international aspirations. It's a solid enough member of this Northern Ireland side, which will have to take on Spain, Yugoslavia and Honduras in the World Cup. Jennings slightly in two minds. Nelson got there just ahead. Forward once again. Watson again on the far angle of the six-yard box. Watson, blocked by Nelson. Wilkins. got a deflection, and Ray Wilkins will certainly claim the goal. It's the first one he scored for anybody since he scored for England against Belgium in the European Championships of 1980. Out by Nelson, and Wilkins again off Nelson and past Pat Jennings. Make it 3-0. It's won by Anderson there. First shot by Watson. It certainly came off Sam Nelson. So 3-0 to England. Sammy Nelson, the unlucky player then. Sanson. Woodcock out to the left. Sanson. Goalkeeper error against Pat Jennings. Nelson and Jennings look at each other with rather forlorn expressions. Woodcock's cross. And Jennings had it for a second and let it go, and in came Hoddle. Disappointing end to his 90th appearance. To be slightly blinded on the first shot. 3 minutes still to go, and suddenly England had the chance of recording their best victory under Ron Greenwood, with Hoddle getting the fourth goal there, their best during his reign. And tonight is the 45th match of his stewardship. It was a 5-1 victory against Northern Ireland in Belfast in 1979, in October of that year. Keegan. And the ball was out. Sanson. Regis. Hoddle. Did well with the chest then, Regis. McCreary gets right with Hoddle. It's Terry Cochran. Nelson. McCreary. Won by Regis. Wilkins looking for Keegan. Woodcock making the run diagonally across the box. And can now wait in the box for the corner. There were quite a lot of flags being waved around Wembley Stadium. Totally different atmosphere in the second half. The goals have come, and the morale has been boosted, both on the field and off. Hoddle with a corner. Met by Keegan. Here's Regis. Woodcock. Corner. The body of Matt Jennings. Came off Keegan. He just pulled it back. Woodcock on the turn, and the foot of Jennings, in fact, turned it away. Wilkins. Regis. Foster. Clements wanting to get into the action. It's just a question of what Mr. Owen has got on his watch for the stoppages, really. There haven't been any injuries of note. It's nice to hear Wembley sounding like this. Here's Hoddle. And the contrast with the quietness that marked so much of the first period couldn't be more marked. McCreary. Jimmy Nicol making the forward run. Donaghy. Well won by Robson. Woodcock. Keegan. Woodcock forward, Regis in the inside right position, and unmarked. Up comes Anderson behind him. Terry Cochran for dead, off Sam Nelson. Anderson. And here's Cochran. He made the second one tell. And that's the last challenge one of the new boys has to make, as Mr. Owen blows the final whistle. And Robson, the scorer of the first goal after 49 seconds. Hoddle, the fourth, with 4 minutes to go. And from the despondency of much of the first half, a great boost to England's confidence, which has been well received by the Wembley crowd. They are all scorers, Robson, Keegan, Wilkins and Hoddle, amounting to a 4-0 home victory.